still see the steeple, a little church on the hill. Still see the steeple, the little church on the hill. There's a line at the altar, and every pew had been filled. I remember the water, the choir singing old hymns. There was a peace in the valley. Oh, as the preacher man he said, in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Spirit, you're washed by the blood and buried with Christ, raised in new life, baptized. I can still hear the sermon. All the people said amen. It was a gift of salvation. Church on the hill.
Thank you. Thank y'all so much.
Still see the steeple, the little church on the hill. There's a line at the altar, and every pew had been filled. I remember the water, the choir singing old hymns. There was a peace in the valley. Oh, as a preacher man, he said, in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Spirit, you're washed by the blood and buried with Christ, raised in new life, baptized. I can still hear the sermon. Said amen. It was a gift of salvation. You could be born again. I remember the power, the Holy Spirit rushing in. There was peace like a river.
Church on the hill.
Welcome, everyone, to the celebration of life for Corey Monroe. We're going to start out by praying together. So why don't we all stand and hold the hand of the person next to you. Let's connect. Heavenly Father, we thank you for what you've done through your son Jesus, sending him to earth to love us, to show us who you are, but most importantly, to die for us and to open up the gates of heaven. We thank you for the free gift of salvation and eternal life, which Corey partook in. We give you all the praise, all the glory. We ask for your presence to be here and the comfort of the Holy Spirit to bring peace and healing as we celebrate his life today. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, Amen. Lot in his short stay on earth. He was certified in flagging, welding, and cooking, which he loved to do. He is survived by his sisters, Michaela, Crystal, and one older brother, David, and mom, Cindy, and father, Larry. At this time, Pastor Don is going to come and sing a song for us. Enjoy.
This song means a great deal to Larry, and he asked me to sing it today, and I'm going to have, just ask, if you know the song, please go ahead and sing along with me. You're welcome to stand, sit, whatever you're most comfortable with. The song's called No Longer Slaves.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave. Into a family, your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave.
Thank you, Pastor Don. Amen. I love the part. He split the sea so I could walk right through it. Just a picture of heaven for us. Right now, we do have some family testimonies, and first to speak would be Brother David.
Thank you. All right. Hi, everyone. For those who don't know me, I'm David, Corey's older brother. Where do I start to explain my brother? Most of you would probably say that he was probably a good son, a good nephew, a good friend. He was so much more to me than any of that. The best way I could probably explain it would be that crooked little grin that he'd say when he'd say something cocky and enjoy it. sorry, guys. basically, the laughter you'd hear after he said one of his inappropriate jokes that I won't repeat because I'm in church. his undying positivity that oozed from his body whenever he was trying to explain, didn't matter what it was, but anything he was trying to explain. And most people will disagree with a lot of things he did agree that he did try to explain, but what I love most about him was his fierce loyalty and love to his family. We didn't always get along, and we didn't always see eye to eye on things. But if I take anything from this, is that he will probably be in heaven, pestering God, telling inappropriate jokes, and waiting for the day that we all come and see him. Thank you, guys.
And Sister Michaela.
Hi, baby. Hi, everybody. I'm Michaela. Corey's older sister. What can I say? Corey wasn't Corey without a blunt in his hand and a candy bar in his pocket. He was also kind enough to share it with whoever he was with. There isn't a better word I could use to describe Corey than serendipitous. Serendipity is defined as finding something good without looking for it. Corey was a blessing to everyone in his life. He was compassionate, kind, caring, and generous. The kind of person who would give you the shirt off his back and feed you before feeding himself. Growing up with Corey, Corey was the baby of the family. And his entire life, he was treated as such. Literally. He was overly curious and never cautious. And he was always causing mischief from the day he was born until the very end. I remember him loving metal Tonka trucks, and he was really never far away from his sister, Crystal. As he grew up, his inner child always stuck around. He loved playing with his nephews, and he never minded playing Barbies with his niece. He loved painting her nails. Corey struggled heavily with depression and various other things, but despite his hardships, he never let it make him bitter. Instead, he just tried to always be better. He stayed loyal and focused on his family more than anything, and he looked up to his pops, and he loved his mama because he was a mama's boy to the very end. In his last few years, he showed immense growth and strength. He got to experience traveling the country. He cooked for crowds, which was his biggest passion. And it brings me great comfort knowing that he got to experience real and true love with my best friend. I got to spend the better part of the last 2 years of his life making once-in-a-lifetime memories with him. And I'll never, ever forget any of those. I know that for a moment in time, Corey was actually truly happy and felt loved. He always walked on the wild side of life, but he never let it change who he wanted to be. He always wanted to be a better person. He always wanted to do great things. And I know that the world may have lost an amazing soul, but I know that everybody great gained the greatest angel to look over us. And I know that Corey's looking down from above with his homies, smoking a blunt, blasting music. And I know he's resting in paradise because that's what he always wanted. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to City Park Church. Sorry it's under such circumstances. Thank you, dear.
You're welcome.
I'm Larry. I'm Corey's father. I was his hero. He looked up to me. He told me he looked up to me. He always did. And unfortunately, it took the loss of him to realize that it's made me a better person. There's one word for Corey that was ambitious. He was always trying to make our family proud. He always had a smile, a candy bar, and a blunt, which he was willing to share at the drop of a hat. No questions asked, he would give you the shirt and shoes off his back to help you. His love for the human race was what kept him alive in this day and age. I remember one day I was visiting him at work at his job, and he stopped for a moment, and he asked the young lady he was working with, he said, "Can you please excuse me for a moment so I can give this young man, this young homeless man, my last $5 so he can go to Mickey D's and get some food?" Seeing him do that made me so proud of him. I also learned that day that he spoke Spanish. I never knew that. He was so talented. He told me, he said, "When you grow up in Rockwood, you have to learn to speak their language." He always knew what to do to cheer me up. But now that he's gone, I look back on his life knowing I'm going to be a better man for knowing and loving him. His passing has made me want to be a person all kids can look up, all kids can look up to for love, for advice, and anything else they may need at any time they feel trapped or threatened or just need to talk. Yes, we've lost an amazing friend, but we've all gained the world's best guardian angel we will ever have. Thank you.
Thank you, Larry. We'll be hearing from Michelle later. If you don't know me, my name is Pastor Bob, and really glad that you've taken the time to come here today. For a pastor, these are the most difficult things. They don't train you in Bible school how to do these things. You know, we've come here this day for a number of reasons. We're here today to pay tribute to Corey. We're here today to show our love and support to all the family. Finally, we're here today to seek and to receive comfort. We would be less than honest if we said that our hearts have not ached over this situation. We're not too proud to acknowledge that we've come here today trusting that God would minister to our hearts and give us strength. The question is, what have we experienced in the past few weeks? Shock that such a young person that we know was killed. Disbelief probably describes what many of us have felt. Anger, perhaps at Corey's killer, or even Corey himself. For others, a sense of disorientation or confusion has been experienced. You may have found yourself struggling to somehow make sense of all this and to get your bearings. And I would venture to guess that all of the people in this auditorium today have faced questions these past few weeks. Probably number one is why. Number two, where we go from here. Number three, what can we learn from this? Questions are totally normal at a time like this, and I'm not standing here in judgment over anyone whose mind may be full of questions. And neither do I stand in judgment of Corey. God is his judge, and from what I personally know, Corey received Jesus Christ as his personal Savior. And I had the privilege of personally baptizing him here in this church. He came here for a while, Sundays, and more often celebrate recovery on Wednesday nights, listening, receiving God's word, and more open to the message as we taught the Bible and taught about a loving and caring God. I believe that he's enjoying his reward in heaven, his mansion in heaven. The Bible talks about streets of gold, and there's the precious, peaceful presence of God. He's free. This memorial service really is not for Corey. He's in heaven. This is a time for us who are still here on earth. He's reached his ultimate destination in the universe. We say that he's departed, but God says he's arrived. God sees things in a different perspective than we do. God never sees his children die. He simply sees them coming home. If Corey could return at this point, he probably wouldn't. Nobody wants to leave the opulence and the peace of heaven sitting side by side with Jesus. But if he could return and say something this afternoon, I know what it would be. He would turn to some scriptures, as he's probably attending the Heavenly Bible School. Job chapter 19, he would say this, first of all, to y'all. He'd say, "For I know that my Redeemer lives." He turned to Proverbs chapter 3, and he would say this, "Y'all need to trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths." He would turn to John chapter 14 and verse 2, and he would read this promise. Jesus said, "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you." Jesus said, "I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." And then last minute this afternoon, I added this scripture in Revelation 21:21. It talks about a little glimpse of heaven, what heaven is really like. Heaven is a real place. It's not some place we just float around in the clouds somewhere. It talks about the city having 12 gates. Those gates are 12 pearls. Each individual gate is one pearl. That's a big oyster. And the street of the city was pure gold, like transparent glass. Wow. Way better than asphalt, amen? You know, As a children's pastor, I always had an object lesson, so I brought my fork today. And there was this one lady, as I tell the story, she was diagnosed with terminal cancer. Was given 3 months to live. And as she was getting her things in order, she contacted her pastor, had him come to the house to discuss her wishes and to plan her celebration of life. She told him the songs she wanted to sing at her celebration, the scriptures she wanted to be read, right down to their very outfit, because she had planned to have an open casket that she would be buried in. She said, "Pastor, in one hand I want you to put my Bible, and in the other hand I want you to put a fork." The pastor looked at her and said, "A fork? What's the fork for?" The pastor stood there looking at the woman. He was surprised, and the woman said, "Well, to be honest," he said, "I'm just quite puzzled." The woman explained it this way to her pastor. She said, "In all my years of church potlucks and dinners and family holidays, I always remember that when the main course was being cleared, someone would inevitably say and lean over and say, 'Keep your fork.' It was my favorite part because I knew that something better was coming, like velvety chocolate cake or deep dish apple pie. Hope they got some good desserts downstairs. Something wonderful, something with substance. So I just want people to see me there in the casket with the fork in my hand, and I want them to wonder, 'What's with the fork?' Then I want you to tell them, 'Keep your fork, the best is yet to come.'" The pastor's eyes welled up with tears as he hugged the woman and said goodbye. He also knew that she had a better grasp of heaven than he did. At the funeral, people were walking by the casket and they saw the pretty dress she was wearing, the favorite Bible, the fork in the right hand, and over again as the pastor stood there, people were talking to each other. They're like, "What's with the fork?" And over again, he smiled. And during the message, the pastor explained the fork. He told the people he could not stop thinking about the fork and told them that they probably would not be able to do that after today. And he was right. So the next time you find yourself reaching for the fork, remind yourself that this life is so short, so temporary. This is our temporary home. Heaven is our permanent home. We're not citizens of this earth. When you know Jesus, we're citizens of heaven. And Corey, right now, his message to you this afternoon is, I'm telling you guys, the best is yet to come. Someday, we will move beyond our tears, our anger, our confusion. We're going to move beyond the questions. His race tragically ended way too early. But he would tell us, you're still here to run your race. We will miss Corey. But I rejoice this day that he is with our Savior, Jesus Christ. And I believe he's in his mansion right now. He has a big deck in the back. And he's sitting in this lounge chair sipping some lemonade. He's looking down. He knows what's going on. When you're in heaven, you're not oblivious to earth. The Bible says there's a great cloud of witnesses cheering us on up in heaven in our race. The people that have gone on before us, they see what's happening spiritually, like in a service like this. And they're cheering us on. They are our cheerleaders. And from this lounge chair, his message to us this afternoon is, folks, friends, family, mom, dad, sister, brother, I want to let you know that heaven is real. Jesus is the King. And if you haven't, you all should give your lives over to him. commit your lives to him, because he died for you. And he's the only one that can set you free from your sadness, your addictions, and your sin. He would also say, and every time you eat, hold that fork and know that this life is temporary. That this devil-ruled earth is not our permanent home. He would tell you this afternoon, don't blame God for my passing. The best is yet to come. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, for Jesus, for his precious gift of eternal life, and for the comfort of the Holy Spirit. In the midst of our natural sorrow, we thank you for your supernatural grace. We thank you for the promise of everlasting life. And in the face of separation, we thank you for the assurance of eternal reunion. We thank you for Corey's life here on this earth. We acknowledge that he is with you now, rejoicing in your presence and enjoying the blessings of heaven. And we look forward to that day when we can all rejoice together. We thank you that we are not without hope or without comfort at this time. We thank you for your presence being very real to each family member and friend here, and that you will especially strengthen and sustain them in the days, weeks, months, and years to come. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, amen. Amen. Pastor Don and Michelle, going to bless us with a song. Oh, no, first we have a video. I'm sorry. We have a video show on the screens there of Corey's life. So let's celebrate as we watch.
Oh, I'm a traveler far from home. I get lost, but I press on. 'Cause there's a mansion and streets of gold where I belong. Yes, there's a day coming soon where the old will be made new, and heaven's glory shines like the morning before our eyes. When we all see Jesus, when we all see Jesus, no more sickness, no more madness, no more pain. When we sing with angel voices, there will be a great rejoicing. Holy, holy, worthy, worthy is the Lamb. No more sickness, no more madness, no more pain.
My name's Michelle Monroe, and I'm Corey's stepmother, and I want to thank each of you for being here today and sharing this with us. I really appreciate it. Pastor Don and I are going to sing a song, and I want to share a little bit about why this song was chosen. So John 3:16 is one of Larry's favorite Bible verses and the first one he ever memorized. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. Corey was a strong believer, and he and Crystal were baptized the same day in this church, and it was a joyous day for our family and for his church family here. And there was a picture of it up there in the slideshow with them all lined up here in front of the church. And Corey had struggles, and we all do. And now he's walking in freedom with Jesus. And because of his strong faith in Christ, I know that Corey would want any of you who don't know Jesus to be able to join him in heaven and to be with Jesus and walk in the same freedom that he is now enjoying. Corey wants to be on your welcoming committee and celebrate with you when you arrive in heaven. So to honor Corey's memory and his father, Larry, we are going to sing this celebration song of the beautiful life Corey had with us. If you know this song, feel free to join in and sing with us.
The best is yet to come. This song celebrates what's coming.
Come to the well that never runs dry. Drink of the water, come and thirst no more. Come all you sinners, come find his mercy. Come to the table, he will satisfy. Taste of his goodness, find what you're looking for. For God so loved the world that he gave us his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever.
Thank you, guys. Great way to end a celebration. And the church ladies and family has provided some food downstairs. So we just please stay. There's a lot of food to be eaten. So let's just celebrate, continue to celebrate together and enjoy one another's company and comfort one another as we do that. My wife, Pastor Sibylle, will pray us out.
Hallelujah. Father God, we just thank you for the day that you have made where we can bring you our pain, where we can come to you in faith and say, have our broken heart and heal it, Jesus. Father, you are the one that says love never fails, and you've done everything to prove your great love to all of us. And Father, I pray as we go on in this day that you're coming with us, that your peace is released over our lives, and that everybody that heard your voice today knows you love them. You came from heaven to earth to reverse all the ugly stuff and the bad stuff. You came to save us. And Jesus, we pray that your love is so tangible right now in everybody's heart, everybody's soul, as we surrender our grief to you. We surrender the loss that we've experienced with the hope that Corey is with you, with the hope that you are with us, and that we have you have a plan for our life that is good. And yes, Father, we thank you that the best is yet to come. And we thank you that we get to taste and see how good you are to all of us in the midst of tragic events. You are here to comfort, encourage, and give us hope. So we ask you, Father, to do your mighty work in all of our hearts and souls today. Come, draw close so we feel your love right now and your comfort and your healing. You are the God that heals the brokenhearted. Have your way today. In Jesus' name, I speak blessing over you all. Amen.
Amen. Let's all stand up. I want to encourage you to give somebody a hug when we dismiss, and hug the family, and turn to your neighbor and say, keep the fort.